DARPA's Offensive and Defensive Hypersonic Programs, HAWC, and Glide Breaker. Hypersonic Air-breathing Weapon Concept, HAWC, and Glide Breaker are DARPA's Offensive and Defensive Hypersonic Programs, respectively, and their program managers discuss what's been done and what's next. Over the last 2 years, DARPA and the teams of Raytheon/Northrop Grumman and Lockheed Martin successfully completed a pair of flight tests of the scramjet-powered Hypersonic Air-breathing Weapon Concept, HAWC. At the same time, DARPA is working the defensive side of the equation with Glide Breaker. Its goal is to research a highly maneuverable kill vehicle to intercept hypersonic weapons during their glide phase. First part of this video about Hypersonic Air-breathing Weapon Concept, HAWC, Program Manager Andrew Tippy Knoedler told in Breaking Defense. Our adversaries are advancing their capabilities in terms of being able to keep us away from their critical military assets. At the same time, we are always on a continuing path to build weapons that are going to take advantage of what we think are some of their vulnerabilities. Hypersonics at speed and higher altitudes than our current cruise missiles. We need to make sure that we have the right mix of weapons systems to keep our adversaries always guessing about what's coming at them, and we need to counter the systems that they have to achieve our objectives. Knoedler Program Manager HAWC told. We don't have weapons that are flying greater than Mach 5 right now, so that changes how they would have to operate their air defense systems. When the Air Force Research Lab and DARPA set up this program, we were looking to the primes to provide a diversity in designs to go after our major objectives, which were flying faster than Mach 5, higher than 60,000 feet, and range greater than 300 nautical miles. What we learned on the flight tests by Lockheed Martin, who was teamed with Aerojet, and Raytheon, who was teamed with Northrop Grumman, is that we did achieve those primary objectives. I wouldn't call it a competition, per se, although it looks like that to the general observer. We, DARPA, always try to exercise, test, and demonstrate anything that we think is going to give the services a choice later on as they try to transition DARPA technologies to the warfighters. Knoedler Program Manager HAWC told. We had a certain number of vehicles that we asked each performer to build, and at this point we are doing the final assembly for each performer. Then we will see whether those are healthy enough to fly over the next few months. Regarding HACM, we have been working closely with the Air Force Life Cycle Management Center at Eglin, and their hypersonic attack cruise missile. Certainly we'll be involved in offering our advice and our lessons learned. The intent was to leverage the work that DARPA and AFRL did for the HAWC program so that they could then go off and build something that the Air Force would like to operate. Knoedler Program Manager HAWC told. We're careful about the materials we use and I'm not going to specify them, but let's just say I'm not picking the exotic materials, thermal barrier coatings, and complicated manufacturing processes that you might see on a space shuttle because I'm not going Mach 25 re-entering the atmosphere. Hypersonics as technology that's hot, it goes into the high-altitude regime, it's high-speed, it's hard, and there's always a bit of hype associated with all hypersonic programs. Knoedler Program Manager HAWC told. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.